Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to learn Standard 8 Mathematics. Today, in this video, we are going to solve revision worksheet. Question number 1. Compare the following numbers. In this question, children, we have to compare the numbers. First one. (8/7, 0). Here, children, the two numbers are given, which is the greater one and which is the smaller one, we have to find out. Here, children, 8/7 is greater than 0. Yeah, children. So the answer will be 8/7 greater than 0. Now, second one. (-5/4, 1/4). Here, children, one number is negative and one is the positive. So, which is the greater one, children? Positive or the negative? Always, children, the positive numbers are greater than negative numbers. So, here, children, -5/4 is smaller than 1/4. So, the answer will be, children, therefore, -5/4. Smaller than 1/4. Now, third one, children. 17/20, -13/20. Here, children, both the numbers are negative. Okay, and we have to see the denominator is same. Yes, children, in this question, both the numbers denominator is same. So, we have to compare the numerators. Here, children, -17 is greater or -13 is greater. Yeah, children, -13 is greater than -17. So, the answer will be, children, -17/20 < -13/20. Now, children, fourth question. 9/7, 0. Here, children, one number is negative and one number is 0. Okay, children. So, which is the greater one, children? -9/ is greater or 0? Yes, children. 0 is always greater than negative numbers. Therefore, -9/7 smaller than 0. Now, the next question number 5th. 40/29, 141/29. Here, children, both the terms are positive and denominator is also same. So, we have to see the numerators. Here, children, the first term has 40 and second term has 141. Which is the greater number, children? Here, 141 is greater than 40. So, the answer, therefore, 40/29 < 141/29. Now, question number 6. -7/11, -3/4. Here, children, denominator is different. So, here we have to make equal denominator. For that, children, we use here cross multiplication. Okay? Therefore, -7 × 4/11 × 4, -3 × 11, 4 × 11. -28. 7 4s are 28. 11 4s are 44. Now, with the next term, -33/44. Here, children, -28 is greater or -33 is greater? Here, children, -28 is greater than -33. Question number 3. Express the following numbers in index form.
First one, 6th root of 9. This is your question, children. 6th root of 9, it is given, children. We have to write this number in index form. So 9 is your base number, children. So now the index will be, children, 1 upon 6, because 6th root is given. Root means, children, denominator. So we will write 9 raised to 1 upon 6. Now the second one, cube root of 17. 17 is your base number, children. Cube root means 1 upon 3. So the answer will be, children, 17 raised to 1 upon 3. Now third, 8th root of 100. So here, children, the base number is 100 and the answer will be, children, 1 upon 8. So 100 raised to 1 upon 8. Fourth one, square root of 256. 256 is your base number, children, and square root is given. So what will be the index, children? 1 upon 2. So the answer will be, children, 256 raised to 1 upon 2. Now, question number 4. Write in the form nth root of A. First one, 15 raised to 1 upon 2. This we have to write, children, in the form of nth root of A. So, answer will be, children, square root of 15, because denominator is what, children? 2, 1 upon 2. See, 1 is the numerator and 2 is the denominator. 2 means, children, square root. So square root of 15 is your answer. Now the second one, 100 raised to 1 upon 8. Here, children, 1 upon 8. 8 is the denominator, means it is your root. So the answer will be, children, 8th root of 100. Now, question number 5. Find the cube roots of the following numbers. Here, children, in this question, we have to find out cube roots of the particular numbers. So, the first question, children, 343. Okay, children, here 343 is not divisible by 2, it's not divisible by 3, and it's not divisible by 5 also, children. Okay, you have to use the test of divisibility that you have learned in your 6th standard, children. So this number is divisible by 7. Here, children, for finding the cube roots, we will use prime factor method. Now, we take 7, children, 343. When we divide, children, we get 49. 49 is again divisible by 7. 7 sevens are. Now, this 7 is again divisible by 7. So, 7 ones are 7. Now, children, therefore, 343 equal to 7 into 7 into 7. Here, children, we are finding the cube roots. So, we make the group of 3 numbers together. Among the 3 numbers, we get 1 number out, children. Therefore, cube root of 343 equal to 7. Now, question number 2. 729. This number is divisible by, children, 3, or you can divide by 9 also. So, here I am dividing by 9, children. 729. When we divide, children, this 729 by 9, we get 81. So 81 is again divisible by 9.
9 nines are 81. So this 9 is again divisible by 9. So we get 1. Therefore, 729 equal to 9 into 9 into 9. Among this 3 number children, we get 1 out because here we are finding the cube root. So we have to make the group of 3 numbers. Among the 3, we take 1 out. Therefore, cube root of 729 equal to 9.
Question number 6. Expand by using expansion formula. Here children, we have to expand this question by using formula. First one, x plus 3 whole bracket raised to cube. By using the formula children, a plus b the whole bracket raised to cube equal to a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. This is the formula children to expand this question. X plus 3 whole bracket raised to cube equal to x cube plus 3 into x square into 3 plus 3 into x into 3 whole bracket raised to square plus 3 whole bracket raised to cube. Now children, x cube will be as it is x cube plus 3 threes are 9 x square plus 3 square is 9, 9 threes are 27x plus 3 cube is 27. This way we have to expand children these questions. Now question number 2, do yourself. Now third question, 2m minus 5 whole bracket raised to cube. Here children, we use the formula a minus b the whole bracket raised to cube equal to a cube minus 3a square b plus 3ab square minus b cube. This formula we will use children to expand this question. 2m minus 5 whole bracket raised to cube equal to 2m whole bracket raised to cube minus 3 into 2m whole bracket raised to square into 5 plus 3 into 2m into 5 whole bracket raised to 2 minus 5 whole bracket raised to cube. Now 2 cube is children 8. So therefore 8m raised to cube minus 2 square is 4 and m square is m square into 5 plus 3 we keep as it is, 2m also we keep as it is children, 5 square is 25 minus 5 cube is 125. Now the next step, 8m raised to cube minus 3 fours are 12, 12 into 5, 60m square plus 6, 3 twos are 6, 6 into 25 we get children 150 minus 125. This way children, we have to expand these questions by using formula. Children, the formula is very important to solve these questions. So learn everyone the formulas. Now the fourth question, do yourself children. Now move to next question.
Question number 7. Simplify 4a minus 3 whole bracket raised to cube minus 4a plus 3 whole bracket raised to cube. Now children, here we have to do simplification. For that we have to use the formula, but here we should not mention that formula. Therefore 4a minus 3 whole bracket raised to cube minus 4a plus 3 whole bracket raised to cube equal to 4a raised to cube minus 3 into 4a whole bracket raised to square into 3 plus 3 into 4a into 3 whole bracket raised to square minus 3 whole bracket raised to cube. Close the bracket, children. Now next, minus 4a whole bracket raised to cube plus 3 into 4a whole bracket raised to square into 3 plus 3 into 4a into 3 whole bracket raised to square plus 3 whole bracket raised to cube. With the help of the formula, children, we have to expand. Now, 4 cube is 64. 64a cube minus 4 square is 16. 16 into 3, we get, children, 64 into 3, we get 144a square. Now, next, 3 square is 9. 9 threes are 27. 27 into 4, we get 108a. And 3 cube is 27. So, minus 27. Now, next, minus 64a raised to cube plus 144a square plus 108a plus 27. Both the bracket you get same, children. Okay. Because the expansion of formula is same, only the sign is different. Now next step, we open the brackets, children. Because in the second bracket, before the second bracket, negative sign is there. So whenever the negative is there, all the sign of the inside the bracket will change. Equal to 64 a cube minus 44 a square plus 108 a minus 27 minus 64 a raised to cube minus 144 a square minus 108 a minus 27. We have opened the bracket, children. Now we have written all together. Now do the cancellation if any number is get cancelled. Now the remaining are minus 144a square plus 144a square. You get minus 288a square and minus 27, minus 27 we get plus. Okay, we do the plus but sign will be minus only. So minus 54. Question number 2. Write the following rational numbers in decimal form. Here, children, this is a rational number 9 upon 14. Okay. This we have to convert into decimal form. For that, children, we have to do simple division. Okay, children. Now, 14 will be outside. 9 will be inside. Now, 9 is smaller than 14. So, first we take 0. And here also we take 0. We get 9. Now here we give the decimal and we take 0. Now 14 6 are 84. Now we subtract, we get, children, 6. Again we take 0 here, children. Now 16 4 are 56. We minus, children, we get 4. Okay, now we take again 0. Now 14 2's are. What we get, children? 28. Now we subtract, we get 2. Okay, 2 here we get and here 1. So 0. Now we take, children, 14 8's are 112. 112. When we subtract, children, from here we get 8 and we take 0. Now 14 5s are, what we get, children? 70. Subtract, we get 10. Okay. Now we take 0. Now, children, 14 7s are, we get 98. We subtract, we get, children, 2. Okay. Now 0. 14 1s are, 14. We get, children, here 6. Okay. What we are getting here? 6. So it means from here is a 6 only the children. So this process will continue again. So here only we children stop. Okay, our remainder is what? 6. So the answer how you will write children? Therefore 9 upon 14 equal to 0.6428571. Now put the bar children, from where you will start the bar? From 4 children, 4 and here. This way we have to write the answer children.
Second question, do yourself. Question number 8, I have explained in my first revision children, do yourself. Question number 9, line A and B, these two are parallel lines. Okay children, so we have to write line A parallel line B. Line L is a transversal. Okay children, now these two angles are corresponding angles. Okay children, this angle is 105, so this angle will also 105. Okay, so we write, therefore major angle X equal to 105, because these two angles are corresponding angles. So corresponding angles. Now we have to find out the value of Y. So how you will find out X and Y? These two angles are vertical opposite angles. So here we will write children, major angle X congruent to major angle Y, and the property is vertical opposite angles. Okay children, therefore major angle Y equal to 105. Now next we have to find out major angle Z. These two angles are linear pair children. These two angles are linear pair. So linear pair major is children 180 degree. Okay, so we write, therefore major angle Z plus 105 equal to 180. Here property linear pair angles. Therefore major angle Z equal to 180 minus 105. We get children 75 degree. Okay.